What is up, folks? It's Alex. Welcome to 5 Minute Friday. And in this video, I've got 6 real quick, easy, practical little tips for when dealing with images in DaVinci Resolve. Now, these aren't the most exciting tips in the world, but they can save you loads of time and hassle, so they're worth making a video on. Now, these are things we're going to look at. There's also time stamps in the description, or you can use the little timeline on YouTube to find the point that you want. So, with that out of the way, let's open DaVinci Resolve and take a look, shall we? Now, before we actually open DaVinci Resolve, whenever you take photos, they'll probably come out looking something like this. You've got a bunch of photos all in an alphanumerical order. Now, that can cause a problem within DaVinci Resolve. So if we hop over to Resolve, I'm on the Edit tab. I'm just going to hop into the Media tab, and then we just need to browse to that folder. Quick tip for you, if you right-click on an empty space, you can add a new location, browse to a specific folder or drive, and then you can just add that as a shortcut to appear on this list on the left, which is what I've done with my folder containing my images. So as you can see, all of those images are just showing as one single file, and it's acting like a bit of a slideshow. You've got this little icon here, the 3 little dots. If you give that a click, then you've got show individual frames. Click that, and then straight away you'll be able to see the individual images, and you can just pick and choose the ones that you want to import, like so. Now we're back on the Edit tab. I've got all of my images here which I want to start working with, so I'm just going to highlight them all and I'm going to drag them onto my timeline. Now you can see that each of my images is 5 seconds long. So if we click on the word DaVinci Resolve at the top left and then come down to Preferences, select User, and then Editing from the left-hand side. And then in the general settings at the bottom, you've got Standard Still Duration. You can pick frames or you can pick seconds. So I'm going to change mine. Mine's currently set to 5 seconds. I'll change that to 10 and then click Save. And then if I just delete these from my timeline and then re-add them, you'll see that now each one is 10 seconds long rather than being 5 seconds long. Now for my next tip, as you can see, we've got these black bars on the left and right hand sides of the screen. That's because we're working with a 1080p project, but images are all at a 4:3 ratio rather than the 16:9 ratio that we need. So to get around that, we need to zoom in, but we've got a bunch of different images. We don't want to do them one at a time. So what we can do, open up the effects library, expand the toolbox, go to effects, and then grab an adjustment clip and just put it on the track above all of your images. Give it a click, open up the inspector, and then in the transform, all I'm going to do is zoom in, and then we can just make that adjustment clip the length of all of my individual photos, and it'll apply the zoom to all of them, and it just makes your life that little bit easier. Now, if you've got a portrait image like I have here, you're obviously going to have much bigger bars over on the left and right hand side. You probably don't want to zoom in because you're going to lose too much of your image. So what you can do, just to make this look a little bit nicer, again, open up the effects library, expand the toolbox. This time we're going to open effects, scroll right down until you see the stylize area, and you want to grab blanking fill. Drag that onto your image, and you see what it will do is just replicate the image in the background, making it blurred, and it just fills out the screen for you. If you give the image a click on the timeline, within the inspector, open the open effects, and then you should see blanking fill within there, and there's a bunch of options for you to change. So you can change how that background image appears, changing the zoom mode. You can blend the foreground image with the background image if you want to. You can change the amount of blur, fade. You can even add a drop shadow. Just have a play, loads of options for you to mess around with in there. Another tip, dynamic zooms. If you're doing a slideshow, you're just showing images like I am here, it doesn't look too bad, it looks okay, but it's a little bit static. We can just add that little bit of motion. If you give your image a click on the timeline, open up the inspector, turn on dynamic zoom, and then underneath the preview window, you've got the drop down, select dynamic zoom. The green is where you start from, the red is where you end. So if you make the box small and then big, you're gonna have a real dramatic zoom. If we just make it just a little bit, something like that, and if we hit play, you can see we've just got that little bit of movement as it's zooming out of the photo, and it just makes it look more dynamic and just makes it look a little bit nicer. And now for my last tip, if you want to add a black border to your images just to make them pop out a little bit, there's a real quick, easy way to do that. Again, within the effects library and the toolbox, This time go to generators and then grab a window, and we're just going to drag that onto our timeline above our images and our adjustment clip. Now by default it's going to look like this, with a big black border and just a white box in the middle. Give the window a click, open the inspector, and then just change the composite mode from normal to multiply. And then multiply will basically make the white bit transparent while we're keeping the black as it is. We can then just zoom in, set the border to the size that we want it. Let's go with that. We can make that the length that we want it. So we're going to cover all of these images. And there we go. We've still got our dynamic zooms set. We've still got the zoom for our adjustment clips, but now we've also added a border just using the window. And that's it for this one. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, thumbs up. Comments or feedback, as always, pop them down below for me. And if you're new here, you enjoy this video, you want to see a bit more, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Thanks ever so much for watching, folks. Take it easy. I'll see you next time. Bye.